Hello guys, this is Indian Medico and in this video we are going to see about Perthes disease. This is a concise presentation for medical students. Perthes disease is also known as Legg Calve Perthes disease. It is a rare childhood hip disorder. Perthes disease is initiated by a disruption of blood flow to the head of the femur. This disruption of blood flow causes avascular necrosis of the head of femur and the bone stops growing. Perthes disease is basically osteochondritis of epiphyses of femoral head. In Perthes disease, the femoral head becomes avascular and deformed. This picture shows the blood supply of the head and neck of femur. This picture shows the difference between a normal head of femur and Perthes disease. As you can see, in Perthes disease, there will be necrotic bone due to avascular necrosis of the head of femur and the head will be deformed. What are the causes of Perthes disease? Perthes disease is caused due to recurrent episodes of ischemia of head of femur. It is precipitated by episodes of synovitis. There are three stages in Perthes disease. They are stage of synovitis, stage of trabecular necrosis, and stage of healing. Now let us see about the clinical features of Perthes disease. Perthes disease usually affects boys in the age group of 5 to 10 years. There will be pain in the hip which radiates to the knee. There can be limping or hip stiffness. On examination, the affected limb shows limitation of abduction and internal rotation. There can also be shortening of the affected limb. How do you diagnose a case of Perthes disease? X-ray reveals collapse and sclerosis of epiphyses of femoral head, as you can see in this picture. The hip joint space will also be increased in case of Perthes disease. Bone scan reveals decreased uptake by head of femur. Catral classified Perthes disease into four groups depending upon extent of involvement of head of femur. These pictures show the four groups of Perthes disease. These depend on the extent of avascular necrosis of the head of femur. Now let us see about the treatment of Perthes disease. The aim of treatment is to prevent the head from misshapening in softening phase. That is, the head should be kept inside acetabulum while revascularization takes place. This can be achieved by conservative methods or surgical methods. Conservative methods include plaster, splint. This picture shows a patient with a splint for Perthes disease. Surgery in the form of containment osteotomy can also be done for Perthes disease. This picture shows a surgically treated Perthes disease. If you have any suggestions, please let me know in the comment section. If you like this video, please like, share, subscribe, and tell your friends about this channel. Thank you.